Hey guys!
Hello everyone!
We're back for episode 3 of Sip Sessions.
Yes!
Couch Cabaret.
We're very excited.
Yes, we
are. MMP news that is coming in. On May 7th, we have the big day of giving.
Big dog.
Where MMP is trying to raise their goal of
$20,000.
Dollars.
So we hope you all donate.
Yes.
Every little bit helps, even just like a dollar, if that's all you can do.
And different MMP students have put together their own fundraiser where they're trying to reach a goal. And I think that if you want to put together your own fundraiser, you can enter in for your chance to win a full year of free MMP tuition for everything. I'm pretty sure. Every workshop, everything you want to do with MMP, which is pretty cool. So,
yes.
Yeah.
And some other news. Some shows are continuing that have been postponed because of the coronavirus, like Moana Jr., Aristocats Kids, and Willy Wonka Jr.
And
Lion King Jr. and Lion King Kids for the homeschool program. So they're all still rehearsing on Zoom. Because, you know, the show must go on, and it will. And we started some other shows. We started Footloose, and we started Cinderella. I'm in Footloose. And the rehearsals, they're going well. We had our read-through, which was, it went very well.
It's all taking place over Zoom.
Over Zoom, which, you know, sometimes with technology, there are little mistakes that happen here and there, little glitches, but,
We worked through it. You're also, for Master Academy, ever since we took just 1 week off when we were trying to figure out what to do with this whole pandemic situation. And so since, like, we just took 1 week off, and then after that we were right back in doing Zoom rehearsals and dance lessons, vocal lessons, and acting lessons. And it's really fun. It's a great time to see our friends, which is pretty cool.
And the only way that we can.
Even though it's virtual. It's still really fun.
Yeah, thankfully we have this platform to do because if Zoom wasn't a thing, girl, I don't even know what would happen.
Thank goodness.
Thank goodness for Zoom.
For technology.
Yeah, for this too.
Speaking of thanking people.
We, as you may have noticed, we look a little different. In a good way. We would like to thank Maribel Usaris for giving us like the studio lights. You can't see it, but they're shining on us.
Yes.
So we have
amazing lighting.
Yeah, she's so kind of doing that to us.
Mm-hmm. Thank you so much. That was so just an act of kindness. We love it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it makes us look professional.
Yes. So fancy.
Yes. We're just waiting for a little second more for people to join so that everyone can get on. Thank you.
Thank you.
Love
that. I hope it looks good.
Yes.
All right.
Okay.
All right. Shall we
get started?
We get started.
Okay.
And
with our jingle.
With our Super Smith siblings jingle.
There it is. All right.
It's Declan and Tristan in a couch cabaret.
All right, Sip Sessions,
episode 3.
Today we have many, many guests for you today. I hope you love them all. We sure do. Everyone, it's a great lineup today.
A wonderful lineup.
A wonderful lineup. So first, we have Whitney. Hey, Whitney.
Hi, Whitney.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Good, thank
Doing
you.
Doing very well. Thank you so much. So what song are you singing today?
Burn from Hamilton.
Oh.
Why'd you pick that song?
Well, Local 4 is actually doing a dance tour right now. And yeah. I kind of wanted to show off a head voice type for me because I normally do belty songs that are really loud. So I wanted to try something new.
Yeah, try that other side of your voice.
Challenging yourself and doing something brand new.
Yeah. So how old are you?
I'm sorry?
How old are you?
I am 14.
14. What grade are you in?
I'm a freshman.
Awesome.
How is online school going for you?
For me, it's pretty easy because I have all of my electives right now, and they're all arts-based. So I have theater and dance, art, and then I have English. So I pretty much have the easiest term possible.
That's nice.
And most enjoyable probably too, because you're doing what you love, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah. Wow. All right. Well, Whitney, we're very excited to hear your
burn. All right, take it away, Whit. Great Yay! Job, Wendy, that's so good. So much
I love your voice singing ballads. It's so pretty.
Thank you so much.
I love the emotion that you have with that song. So good. All right, so tell us about some of your hobbies.
Some of my what?
Your hobbies.
My hobbies. Well, I really like to sing, as you know, kind of just did. But I like to draw and paint, and I've been doing a lot of that. In this quarantine time, So yeah, I have quite a few little works of art hidden around the house.
I love that.
What have you painted?
Yeah. What's your favorite one?
Well, I've done a couple of things. I've done some sketches. Some of them have been for my art class at school.
Oh.
But Brooke's brother had a birthday and he was into race cars, so I painted him a race car on a big board, which was really fun to do.
I love that.
Aww. Wow. All right, and what has your favorite MMP show you've done been?
I loved all of them, but I gotta say Once on This Island, mostly because I do remember talking to Bryce and Anne-Marie and saying, guys, we gotta have sand. And I remember going through the process, I called Lowe's, and I was like, I don't know, I think I was 12 at the time, and I was like, a 12-year-old calling Lowe's saying, I need sand!
Oh, yeah.
It was so much fun because we had sand and I love dancing with sand. That
was very fun.
It made art, it made it so fun.
Like the experience like so much better.
Yeah.
It's much more fun.
Something about it.
Yeah.
It was so cool. Just, oh my gosh. We really got into character with the sand.
Yeah. What's your favorite role been?
My favorite role? I gotta say Scar was a really fun one, also because I had no idea I was gonna get that. I went into that show thinking, oh, I could be Nala, I could be Zazu, I could be young Nala too, I could be all these people, and then I didn't even have Scar anywhere because I don't really play villains that much. And then I got it and I was like, I like being evil.
Yeah.
I love that when you explore new parts of yourself and creativity. It's so cool. Yeah, playing villains can be very fun and fresh.
It's hard for that.
Yeah. All right. Well, Whitney, thank you so much for singing for us.
It's such
today.
A good job.
Thank you.
Have a great night.
Bye.
You
bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye.
Aww. Whitney is in Level 4 Master Academy along with me. And she has been a master with me for a long time, for a while. Always such a hard worker. So we love having seen me on the master and everything.
Yeah,
and
seeing her grow from years. Like, she's like, I'm just not. Yeah, when I met her, she's so small.
Yeah.
And then she's growing up. So
freshman next. Yeah. All right.
Our next guest is
Bella. Hi.
Hey, Bella.
Hi, Bella.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Good. Thank you.
Great. Thank you so much. All right. How old are you and what grade are you in?
I'm 12 years old and I am in 7th grade.
Awesome.
Nice.
All right. What are you singing for us today?
I'm singing Quiet from Matilda.
Oh,
no. Aww. Matilda was the first Broadway show we ever saw.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool.
No, that's such a beautiful song. I love that song so much. All right.
All right. Well, we're very excited.
I'm excited to see you.
Yeah.
All right. Take it away, Bella.
Have you ever wondered what I have about how when I say red? For example, there's no way of knowing if red means the same thing in your head as red means in my head when someone says red, and how if we are traveling at almost the speed of light and we're holding a light, that light which did travel away from us at the full speed of light, which seems right in a way, but I'm trying to say I'm not sure, but I wonder if inside my head I'm not just a bit different from some of my friends. These answers that come into my mind unbidden, these stories delivered to me fully written. And when everyone shouts like they seem to like shouting, the noise in my head is incredibly loud, and I just wish they'd stop. My dad and my mom and the telly and stories would stop just for once. And I'm sorry, I'm not quite explaining it right, but this noise becomes anger, the anger is light. And it's burning inside me, would usually fade, but it isn't today. And the heat down is shouting, and my heart is pounding, and my eyes are burning. And suddenly, everything is quiet. Like silence, but not really silent. Just that still sort of quiet. Like the sound of a page being turned in a book. Or a pause in a walk in the woods. Quiet. Like silence, but not really silent. Just that nice kind of quiet. Like the sound when you lie upside down in your bed. Just the sound of your heart in your head. And though the people around me, their mouths are still moving, the words they are forming cannot reach me anymore. And it is quiet, and I am warm. Like I've served into the eye of the storm.
Oh my God, oh,
that was beautiful.
So much emotion. You connect that character so well.
Oh,
it was so beautiful.
Oh my goodness, it's just so crazy to see and so fun to see how much you've grown since I met you. A fun fact, when I was in fourth grade and you were in kindergarten, we were paired up as buddies at school. And it was so fun. We got to do little crafts together and go to mass together, and it was so much fun getting to know you. I think we have a picture together from that time. We were both so little. And then when I got to hear you sing at the Laurel Bundy Masterclass, I was like, oh my goodness, you sang Born to Entertain, right?
Yeah.
Born Ruthless, and oh my goodness, that song is so like powerful and like showing
yeah.
It was amazing. And then when you were in James and Joy H, oh my goodness, phenomenal. So I wanted to ask you, what has been your favorite memory at MMP so far?
My favorite memory is probably getting to sing for Laura Bell Bundy at the masterclass.
Nice. And why did you love it so much? What made it your favorite?
It was just really like really cool getting to sing for her.
Yeah.
Hear her feedback on the song too.
Mm-hmm. Always. Yeah, she's a pretty big name. I'm getting to
a big name.
Yeah, I got to sing for her too, and it was so beneficial to get all that feedback from her. So much fun.
Yeah. So what are some of your hobbies?
I like skateboarding, running, reading, writing. I like playing with my dog too. And I like doing community service projects.
Oh, awesome.
What do you do for community service?
Well, I go out into my park because we have fields and like creek by the park. And so I just go and pick up trash by
the car.
Very nice. I love that.
So what was your favorite MMP show and role?
My favorite show was Xanadu the first time. And my favorite role was Jinx.
Yeah, so I miss Jinx. We started almost like next week a year ago. I can't believe it's been that long.
I know.
That was such a fun show.
Started it. You're the general.
You were so good in that show.
Amazing. I know that was a time where I was like, whoa, where is the time? time gone. You've grown up so much. Yeah. Amazing.
That's one of my favorite memories. Mm-hmm. It's like getting close with that that cast into Giant Peach.
Yeah.
Aww. What was your favorite song to sing in Jinx?
Oh yeah. Mm-hmm.
Middle of a Moment.
Awesome. Mm-hmm. Well, that's such a beautiful song.
Written by the amazing Pascal Paul.
Who's written The Greatest Showman, Dear Evan Hansen.
The lyrics to La La Land.
Mm-hmm.
Amazing composers.
Very amazing.
All right. Well, Bella.
Hi, Bella.
Thank you.
Oh, I did want to say, great accent in that song.
Oh, yeah.
Someone come to that.
And we did see that a fun fact about you is that you've been obsessed with British people.
Yes. You're very young.
I love that.
And it paid off.
For James and for this, because both of you have to do a British accent. I love it.
All right.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Bella. Wonderful job.
Thank you.
Bye.
Aww. I love it. I need to find that picture of us when I was 9 years old and she's probably like 5 or 6. So fun.
Yeah, she's come a long way too. Everyone has.
It's so fun to see people grow now that we're getting older.
Mm-hmm.
But,
Anyway. All right. Our next guest is Brooke.
Beland,
yes.
Hi.
Hey, Brooke.
Hi, Brooke.
How are you?
I'm good. You?
Good. Thank
really
you.
Well, thank you. Yes. All right. How old are you and what grade are you in?
I'm 16 and I'm a sophomore.
Awesome. What are you singing for us today?
I'm singing Someday from the Wedding Singer.
Oh, yes!
I know that. Yeah. That's such a fun and like happy and feel good song. You know?
I know.
I love it. Why'd you pick that song?
I don't know. I thought it was like really cute and like she seems so happy because she's like, I can't wait to get married. I'm like, oh, that sounds fun. So
that is a really fun song.
All right,
we can't wait to hear you sing it.
I'm excited. All right, take it away.
Okay, thank you. She turns around and she meets his gaze. The lights are dim, there's a smoky haze. They share a smile and a secret wave. It's a moment filled to say. They start to move across the floor. The room is frozen, wanting more. The happy couple on display, but nothing standing in their way. It's so romantic, I could die right here, right now. It's gonna be that way for us. I know somehow, someday when it's me, I'll know our love was meant to be. Not one single complication or cause for hesitation. Someday when the dream is coming true, all you'll need is me and all you'll need is you. They stop and pose for a photograph. He jokes around just to make her laugh. The room is full, but they're alone. They have a language of their own. And I'm so jealous, I could cry, and yet I know it won't be long before you say, we're good to go. Someday when it's me, I know our love was meant to be. Not one single complication or cause for hesitation. Someday when the dream is coming true, all you need is me and all we need is you. I know not every marriage lasts when things go bad. I've seen the warning signs, I call them mom and dad. But soon you'll take my hand and pledge your love to me. Till then I'll just get married vicariously. Someday when it's me, I'll know our love was meant to be. Not one single complication or cause for hesitation. Someday when the dream is coming true, all you need is me. And all you need is you.
Great job, bro.
Love it. Oh, such a fun and poppy
song. Yeah.
Love it. Oh, so cute. Awesome. All right. Now, what are your favorite hobbies to do?
My favorite hobbies are acting, singing, dancing. I play piano, and I love traveling.
Ooh. Where do you like to travel?
Going to the Caribbean a lot. I've been to, like, Jamaica and, like, Cozumel and stuff like that.
Cool.
How fun.
Yeah.
So where's your favorite MMP memory been?
My favorite memory? I think it's the first time I went to JTF in Atlanta, and I loved it so much because it was the first time I was going there, and there was, like, thousands of other, like, theater kids that loved it just like me, and it was just such a good environment for other people to, like, interact with new people.
It really
is.
Yes,
it really is. Yeah. Oh, it's such a good
A welcoming place. Environment.
Yeah.
Your mood just hikes up right away.
Crazy.
What is your favorite MMP show been, and your favorite ever role?
My favorite show is probably Curtains, and my favorite role is in Music Man when I was Oliver. It was super fun because playing a man.
Yes. Being in the quartet is not easy. It's harmonies to memorize, but it's also so fun. Like,
yeah, it was so fun, but it was a lot of work.
Oh yeah, sure. Awesome.
Wow. And Curtains was such a fun show.
Yeah.
I wasn't in Curtains, but I saw it three times. Half of your show.
Dedication.
Dedication indeed.
All right, Brooke. Thank you for saying that. Was so good.
Good, thank you.
All right, you have a good night.
You too. Bye.
Bye. Aww, love it.
That's such a fun song. So poppy. Like,
I know.
Like bubblegum pop.
Bubblegum pop. All right. Our next
guest.
Juliet.
Hello.
Juliet.
Hi.
We can't see you. But is your camera on?
Well, we'll just wait.
She'll come back.
Is it working?
It is not.
Not yet.
But that's okay.
Yes.
Can you see me?
No, it was loading. Now it's just a black screen. Now it's off.
That's okay.
I can't see. Can you see me?
We can
now. So, is it your...
Can you see me?
Does it say that your camera is on? Maybe. Huh.
It's okay.
That is okay. Maybe. Mm-hmm. Should move.
To the next person?
So should we definitely get him? But we're going to wait for Okay. So we're
going
to move on to the next person. Okay. Our next guest is Izzy. Oh, hey. Hi, Izzy.
Hey, Izzy.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good.
Are you excited?
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh, good.
How old are you?
I'm 9 years old.
And what grade are you in?
I'm in third grade.
Aww, love it.
What song are you gonna sing today?
Today I'm gonna sing Notice Me Horton from Seussical.
Oh,
Oh,
I love that song.
It's one of my favorite songs in the whole show. Mm-hmm. Why'd you choose this song?
It's personally my favorite song in the whole show.
Have you done it at MMP?
No, not yet. Like, I've done Seussical, but I haven't had the part of Gertrude.
Oh, okay. But you did do Seussical before?
Yes.
Who are you?
I was a who.
Yes, I was a who the first time I did it. Yes. Mm-hmm. What a fun life.
Yeah.
Okay, well, I'm excited to see you.
Yes, we're very excited.
All right, take it away, Izzy.
It's taken all my courage to approach you, not to mention all my stamina to follow you across the hills and deserts. But I feel as if I'm ready to confess to you the feelings that I've hidden with great diligence and labor. Behind the facade of your odd little next door neighbor. My eyes are too small. I have very large feet, and I'm not very proud of my pitiful. But I've now got a tail that is something to see. Oh, notice me, Horton, feather by feather. This is your next door neighbor calling. Notice me, Horton, Horton together. We could be great. Oh, notice me, Horton. Put down the clover. This is your next door neighbor. Call me. There's a new leaf. Your neighbor's turned over. I was just a no one only yesterday. You showed up and showed me something more. Now I've become someone who has someone to believe in and to be. I will not give up hope. I was hooked from the start when I noticed your kind and your powerful heart. So notice me, Horton. Notice me, Horton. Notice me, Horton. The way I notice.
Yeah.
Yes, so good.
Good job, Izzy.
Thank you.
So what are some of your hobbies?
I like to write and sing and act.
Yes. What do you like to write?
I like to write like stories about some characters that I made up.
I Ooh. Love that.
So do you like make multiple stories with the same characters in them?
Like a series? Or do you just make anything?
It's kind of like a series kind of thing.
Cool.
I love that. Mm-hmm. Awesome. I saw that you have a golden doodle.
Yeah.
Oh, is it a boy or a girl?
It's a boy.
What's his name?
Ziggy.
Ziggy. Ziggy. We have a cockapoo. You look kind of alike.
Which is, yeah, she's a cocker spaniel poodle mix. And golden doodle, is that a golden...
Is that a golden retriever and a poodle?
It's a golden retriever and a poodle, so yes.
Oh, okay. Nice.
So the arts have maybe look a little bit alike.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, all of that.
All right, well, what's your favorite MMP memory?
My favorite MMP memory is going to Disneyland and taking classes and getting to know all the people that are in my level.
It's so much fun to go take classes at Disneyland, right? What classes did you take there? Did you take an acting class?
We took singing, acting, and some dance.
Nice. Oh, they're always so much fun there. They're so welcoming and always inspire you to be the best you can be, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, it's so much fun. Plus, you get to go to Disneyland.
What's your favorite ride at Disneyland?
Pirates of the Caribbean.
Oh, yes.
So iconic.
I love the water smell there. I love the smell. That makes me miss Disneyland so much.
Aww.
Oh, love.
Oh, Izzy, you did such a great job.
You did.
Oh, thank you.
All right, great job, Izzy. Bye.
Thank you.
Bye.
All right.
So good.
Yeah. Right.
Now, next, we're going to try.
Go back to Juliet. See if that works.
Can you see
me?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Hi.
Okay.
Hey, Juliet.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good.
Good.
Awesome. How old are you? And what grade are you?
I'm 13 years old, and I'm in eighth grade.
Yes.
I always think you're older than you are.
Yeah, I was like, what?
Yeah, people do.
What song are you singing today?
I'm singing Don't Rain on My Parade from Funny Girl.
Iconic.
Yeah.
Wow.
Oh, and I saw you love Leah Michelle. She very much made that song super iconic, along with Barbra Streisand first and foremost.
Yes. But like with Ari,
nowadays,
she did it because of Glee.
Yeah, she has such an amazing voice. I like idolize her so much.
Yeah. Yeah. Did you watch Glee?
Yes.
I have a question.
I watched it like 5 times.
I have a question for you. Did Rachel Berry or Santana Lopez do the Run of My Parade then?
Definitely Rachel Berry.
That's
me.
What I.
Like, I mean, what? Yes, she did, but I love Santana's version.
It's a lower
key. They both did good.
Okay. Why'd you pick this song?
I picked this song because it's always been a song that I like really loved singing, and I feel like it's perfect because for a cabaret, because it's like so entertaining to watch and listen to. And I just love this song.
Yeah. Yes. All right. Let's take it away.
Yes. Yes.
Got it. Hold on. Okay. One again. Don't tell me not to live, just sit and putter. Life's candy and the sun's a ball of butter. Don't bring around a cloud to rain on my parade. Don't tell me not to fly, I've simply got to. If someone takes those spill, it's me, not you. Who told you you're allowed to rain on my parade? I'm marching my band out, I'll beat my drum. And if I'm found out, you'll turn it back, sir. At least I didn't fake it, hat, sir. I guess I didn't make it, but whether I'm a rose of sheer perfection, a freckle on the nose of life's complexion, the cinder or the shiny apple of its eye, I gotta fly once, I gotta try once, only can die once, right, sir. Oh, like this, juicy, and you see, I gotta have my bite, sir. Get ready for me, love, cause I'm a comer. I simply gotta march, my heart's a drummer. Don't bring around a cloud to rain on my parade. I'm gonna live and live now. Get what I want, I know how. One roll for the whole shebang. One throw, that bell will go clang. Eye on the targeted limb. One shot, one gunshot, and bam! Hey, Mr. Ornstein, here I am. I'll march my band out. I'll beat my drum. And if I'm found out, you turn it back, sir. At least I didn't fake it, hat, sir. Guess I didn't make it. Get ready for me, love, cause I'm a comer. I simply gotta march, my heart to drummer. No, nobody, no, nobody is gonna rain on my parade.
That song fits so well in the voice.
Your voice has such a nice tone to it. I just love it.
Yeah, I saw Cooper comment, rich voice. It's such a rich voice. Yeah.
Love it.
Yeah. So what are some of your hobbies?
I really enjoy painting and drawing and like being crafty. And I also really like makeup. So like being creative with like eyeshadow palettes and stuff and creating new looks.
Wow. Ooh. Do you like to watch beauty gurus on YouTube?
Yes.
Who do you like to watch?
Bretman Rock, James Charles, of course. So many other, like Jeffree Star,
I love Jeffree Star and James Charles. I just watch them to look for fun.
Yeah.
That's so much fun. What has been your favorite look that you have ever created?
Probably like a sunset look. Like I have it posted on my Instagram. It's like a sunset. So it like goes from yellow to red. And then on the underline I did like blue.
I wish I was that good at makeup. And Juliet, what is your favorite MMP show you've done, Ben?
Probably a tie between Once on This Island and Mary Poppins. Yeah, because I loved both the shows.
Those shows were so much fun.
I know.
Both of those are honestly, I think, maybe my two favorites as well. Once on This Island was just so fun. It was, I don't know, such a cool feel. Maybe it was the sound effect.
And the smell that was out the
whole time. Oh, yeah, we think air fresheners for like a summer,
like Hawaii.
Beach.
Yeah.
And what has your favorite MMP memory been?
Probably the whole week the level fours and us went to Disney World because we just made so many memories and I feel like I made like a family and it was so fun.
Yes. Disney World was so fun. What was your favorite ride at all four of the parks?
Probably Space Mountain. I just wanted to go on it so many times and I like loved it.
Space Mountain was really fun. Disney World was so much fun. It was an amazing trip. Even, oh my goodness, with our flight issue at the end of our trip. So happy. Do you want to explain to our viewers?
About what?
About our flight, how they delayed our flight and then said our flight would not leave until the next morning.
Oh, yeah. That was so crazy. Okay, so we were, like, at the airport and, like we were waiting to board our flight back home and we heard over the speaker or whatever throughout the airport that our flight was going to be delayed like about 2 hours or so. And then as like it went on, it was like, actually we're gonna be staying overnight. And then so we were like all freaking out and like, oh, like people were like, oh my God, sleepover. And then some people were like,
Yeah, I was one of those who was like, no, I have to go to school the next morning.
I was like, no, I want to stay. I don't want to go.
But we got through it. We persevered.
Yes.
All right.
What times?
Traveling with groups of 40 plus people.
Yes.
I love that. It's so much fun.
Props to Amory and Bryce for doing that.
Thank you for taking it.
Trips.
Yeah. All right.
Juliet, thank you so much for sharing your trip today.
Wonderful. All right, bye. Well, we saw a comment. Oh, Reagan.
Oh, hey, Reagan.
Hi.
Reagan's our next guest. How are you?
I'm good. I miss you guys. How are you?
We miss you too.
How are you doing?
Doing very well.
The best of
you. We watched The Wizard of Oz last night.
Yes, you keep watching movies. You keep Snapchatting me and I'm like, oh, they keep watching movies. I love it.
We watched Zootopia. But the night before Easter, my mom was still like,
it's an Easter movie.
That's my favorite. I remember when you showed Madison and I Mean Girls for the first time in that whole day, and you introduced Madison to Sour Patch Strawberry, and there's so many memories at your house.
Oh my gosh, everyone if you, well, maybe when this is all over, but you can still go to Target. Try to find Sour Patch strawberries.
You know how they have Sour Patch watermelon?
They're Sour Patch strawberries. And they used to be only at like the diverse Targets, like Target on Broadway.
Diverse Target? It's true.
But they're delish. They're so, so, so good.
I have to agree.
Yeah.
We, yeah. Okay.
Anyway, what are you singing today?
I'm singing Middle of a Moment from James and the Giant Peach.
Ooh.
Bella's favorite song that she sang when she was James.
I know, I heard and I was like, well, now there's pressure.
And how old are you and what grade are you in?
I am 18 and I am a senior in high school, recently 18.
Yeah.
Oh, yes. Yes.
A few weeks ago.
You're an adult.
Happy. I've
had enough Zoom.
Let's talk real fast about how, so, on your birthday, so you're the director of Arrest the Cats Kids.
Oh, yes.
I am.
You move to Zoom, as well as everything, every other show that we're right now. And they sang happy birthday to you, right?
They did.
On Zoom, all the delays.
4 to 10-year-old.
I love it.
It was very cute and very hard with headphones in. I can't really change the volume on Zoom, so it was just loud, and I had to, like, take one of them out, but it was very cute. It made my day.
How's Arrest the Cats going on Zoom?
It's going great. It's really great to see all their faces every Saturday because we have rehearsal Saturday mornings at 10 a.m., which is, for me, it's early. But to get to see them and have them continue to dedicate themselves and be working on the songs and working on the dances and everything, it means a lot. And I keep practicing their lines is the only thing I say, but that can go at any age range, and they're killing it.
Yeah. Love that you're showing dedication and to your students.
Yeah. All right. Well, take it away.
Cool. Thank you. If this is what my family has to be, then I don't need one watching over me. A family doesn't make you sleep outside. A family doesn't laugh and say you lied. Remember what a home is. Think of how your life should be. But you're stuck in the middle of a moment. Can't crawl out of where you are. Only steps away, the world's okay, but you can't see that far. Stuck in the middle of a moment, you're halfway to somewhere new. Can't go back, you're moving through. You'll have to think in ways you've never thought. You'll have to make the best of what you got. Find the answers hiding in between. See a door that no one's ever seen. Something's there, you feel it. Stop to look, it's all around. So you're stuck in the middle of a moment. No clear path, no shining star. Only steps away, the world's okay, but you can't see that far. And there, in the middle of a moment, you're halfway to somewhere new. Can't go back, keep moving through. Cause there is magic. Now you know you make magic. Made it grow and marvelous, wonderful things can come true. In the middle of a moment.
Reagan, what is your favorite hobby that you do?
I just tell you them all. I love the whole theater thing, singing, acting, dancing, tapping. And I used to play soccer, but I gave that up, so that was the right choice. I love video editing and making short films. All like my first semester of this year, we made like a ton of like 5 minute to, or like 1 minute to 5 minute short films. And they were super fun and something that I didn't know that I enjoyed, but I love doing it. And just video editing of sorts. Yeah, I play video games here and there, but I'm not like a gamer, so.
Explain to the viewers what you did for your video with Haley Truong.
He had an assignment, yes.
You can explain.
An assignment to do duets for Master Academy, and I was paired with Haley, and we chose Unworthy of Your Love from Assassins. But since we had to make a video, Haley and I were like, let's go all out. And so like, it was pretty normal in the beginning, but then like, I was like looking off in the distance and I had like a mini Haley like up here and like edited that. And I like put our faces on two people with guns cause assassins, and like did some color tints, made it a really weird zany music video, but it was fun.
It was so fun. I was very impressed by your editing skills. That was very good. It was, it really was. It was really well done, especially when you guys, because we're obviously not together and you guys did it separately, but you still sounded together the whole time. It was great.
She was joking at first to like make it extra, and I was like, no, I want to do it. I want to edit it. I want to make it as crazy as we can. And we did that, so.
We all enjoyed it very much.
All right, so what is your favorite MMP show event, and what is your favorite role?
My favorite show is a tie between Rent and Mary Poppins. But my favorite role would be Bert in Mary Poppins. But just Rent, they're two like very different shows, clearly. Rent and the like family bond that was built was just amazing. And to be like so vulnerable on a stage was something I hadn't experienced. But Mary Poppins, Bert was just a dream role. And getting to do that was so fun with you, Tristan, and with you, Declan.
Yeah.
We've gotten to reprise our role. We've done it twice.
Yes, we have.
In the full show and JTF West, which you talked about on one of the previous, our first episode. Yeah. Good time.
What is your favorite MMP memory overall?
Memory. So it comes from Spelling Bee, the 25th annual Putnam County Spelling Bee. And my favorite memory was closing night. Getting to play Vice Principal Panch and just have like control over the show was super fun. But if you don't know the secret about the show, I'm going to spoil it for you right now. Declan, obviously, you know. Tristan, you know.
Bye.
We have to get rid of the audience spellers one by one. But for the last one, we have to make it extra dramatic. So when we have them, when we have to get rid of them, we call them up and we give them a fake word that they spell right no matter what. And then they have to sit down and we immediately call them back up and then give them like a really hard word.
Everyone's like, what?
Closing night, we had Haley's older brother, Ellis, was our last speller. And he was
so impressed. I remember I was in the audience and I was like, wow, Ellis is a really good speller.
He was doing really well. And so I was like, well, I have to play with him and make it more fun. So I gave him the fake word, which was like Catterjunes or Kinney Margle or something like that. And he got it right. And so then we sent him back to his seat. And right before he sat down, we called him back up again. And he walked up all confused. And then Madison and I had brainstormed putting this one word in the show. We only added one word and we did Macarena, which the definition was just me awkwardly doing the dance, sitting down. And when he asked for it in a sentence, I said, hey, Macarena, which got the laugh we needed. So that was good. And then he spelled that right. So I was like, yes, this is going perfect to plan. We sent him back down to his seat, although he asked if he'd be allowed to. And I said, you can try. And then we brought him back up and I gave him the word xerothalmiology. And when he asked for the definition, I said no. But then I gave it to him because he asked with a nice please.
Can you spell it for us?
Of course. Xerophthalmiology. Xerothalmiology.
Nice.
That was correct.
I've worked with those notebooks for so long.
I'm sure you have a quite wide range of knowledge of words from spelling bee and how to spell them.
Yeah. I don't really use them all that much, but I do remember, like, vaguely, like, the definitions and the sentences and, like, how to spell most of them. And, like, I'll hear a word once and I'll, like, it'll be like a tick. Like, I'll have to be like, wait, what? And think of the definition and sentence.
Yeah.
All right.
Okay. So thank you, Reagan.
Thank you, Reagan.
Thank you.
It's great to talk to you.
Yes. Great job. Works
always with the Smiths.
Yes.
All right.
Thanks
Bye.
For singing for us. Yeah.
Bye.
Hi, Caitlin.
Caitlin! Oh my goodness! Hello.
How are you guys?
Oh my god! How are you doing?
Oh my gosh! I'm good. I'm as good as I can be in quarantine. You know.
Mm-hmm. How have you been, like, through college and everything?
Yeah, this is an alumni of MMP. I
haven't seen you guys in like years. It's been crazy, but yeah. College has been super fun. It's been an amazing experience. Really hard, but really good. I have finals starting on Monday, and then I'm done. So then everything will be over.
Good luck with finals. Yes. What song are you singing today?
I will be doing I'm Not Afraid of Anything from Songs from New World.
Love that song. Love. Why'd you pick it?
I don't know. It's always been a song. It's like my go-to song if I just need to like de-stress sing for like 15 minutes. And then, I don't know, just like, it's funny, like listening about it, it's like, I'm not afraid of anything. But like, everyone is super scared of everything, like all of the time right now. So it's like, just kind of an interesting look of like, I'm just not going to be afraid of anything.
Oh,
maybe.
Very
I don't
nice.
Know.
Oh, I love that. That's a great answer.
That is.
Great reason.
Yeah, all right. Take it away. I'm excited to see it.
Thank you. Jenny's afraid of water. I mean, she swims so well, but still, she's afraid of water. So she won't go near the sea. Not me. And Katie's afraid of darkness. I mean, she sleeps and all, but still, she's afraid of darkness. So when the lights are out, she has to hold my hand. I don't understand. I'm not afraid of anything, be it mountains, water, dragons, dark or sky. I'm not afraid of anything. I would give up what they want without a trial. Another mile, I'm not afraid. Daddy's afraid of babies. I mean, they got through me, but now he's afraid of babies. I guess he's scared of what they'll be. Not me. Mama's afraid of crying. You know, she tries to hold it in, but she's afraid of crying. And she can look at you with tears stuck in her eye. And I don't know why. I'm not afraid of anything, be it growing old or going out of style. I'm not afraid. where's the challenge if you never try? So watch me fly. I'm not afraid. And I feel the calling of adventure, and I feel the ringing in my ears. The lights are glaring, trumpets blaring, I'm right here. And I feel the calling of tomorrow, and I feel the stirring in my bones. And David loves me. He's afraid to tell me. Listen to the calling of excitement. Can you feel the pounding of my heart? The lights are ready, pulse is steady, I can start. Never miss the calling of a challenge. Blessing on the water and the stones. And David loves me. He's afraid to tell me. David loves me. He's afraid to hold me. He's afraid to trust me, and he'll always be. He's afraid of me. Well, I'm not afraid of anyone. I'm sure to win with anyone at all. Let them call and watch them fall. 'Cause after all, I'm not afraid.
Yeah.
Lovely.
So beautiful.
Thank you. So you have such a wide range. It's so great to hear. I love it.
I've missed your voice. I've missed your voice.
Oh my gosh, thank you. I miss you guys so much.
Yeah, I miss you.
And so does Ken, and so does Mackenzie Ann.
Oh my gosh.
Oh yes, I wanted to ask you.
What college, for everyone who's watching,
everyone, for all the viewers,
what college are you attending and what are you majoring in?
Okay, I am at William Jessup University. It's like a Christian school up in Rockland, and I'm majoring in theater with a concentration in musical theater. And yes, I think that was all the questions.
Yes, awesome.
Good to know.
Yeah.
All right, and can you give us some fun facts about you?
Yeah, sure. Okay. I had to I lost all thoughts when that question was. I don't think I've ever eaten a Pop-Tart. I've never successfully seen all of the Star Wars movies. My ankles crack like nobody's business.
Wow.
Yeah.
Like in a fine way, or like crack, like.
No, when you're rolling.
Oh, okay.
And it'll be like, and like everyone's coming. So it's fun.
Interesting. Oh, God.
That's funny.
What is your favorite show at MMP been?
Oh, my gosh. There's so many. I think one of my all time favorites will probably be Seussical. Very first time we did it, way back. And it was just because, oh my gosh, it was so weird being in the black box tilted for first times that I was in there, and just everyone was having so much fun all of the time.
Yeah, for all the viewers that don't know, so at Kasumas Oaks, we use the black box, and when you walk in, It was like proscenium style. So it was only one
was
side
like
of
the box. Like the TAC, like the big theater, but in
but
black box.
Smaller.
But smaller. Yeah, it was so cool.
It was, yeah.
And that was the first time MMP's ever done Seussical out of 10 times or something.
Including all like the elementary shows. Yeah,
including all elementary.
Time, and that's so
good. Yeah. What is your favorite MMP memory?
Ooh, okay, the first time we all went to JTF West in like the very first time when we were all like rehearsing to get ready, and it was like the day before, and we were all laying on the floor of like what used to be the warehouse, and we were like, well, this is exciting. I'm not gonna sleep tonight. And then we just like texted each other all night long, all the way to the airport. And it was so cool, like, cause we were all so close level threes, like so excited to go over for the first time, you know?
Yeah, that was such a fun trip.
That was so fun. And it was MMP's first experience at a JTF ever. And who is, look at where it has led us now. Yeah.
Now so many people,
so many people have gone, so much fun. It's so special that we were all able to experience that for the first time.
Yeah.
That's such a long time ago. Wow.
2016.
Wow.
Crazy.
Ah. All right, Caitlin. Thank you so much for coming on.
It was so great talking to you.
Thanks for having me. I miss you guys. It's so good to see you and everyone else.
Yes.
Bye, Caitlin.
Bye.
Love that. That was our last.
It was our last performer
of
the night.
Yes. But don't fret. We have another episode next week.
Next week?
Yes. We did see two questions that we thought were pretty interesting from Jonathan Pius Williams, who was G, as you all may know him. He was a contestant.
He was a guest on the first episode.
Yes, he was. And he said, Declan, what's your favorite role Tristan's played? And Tristan, what is your favorite role Declan's played? And we're like, So
I can go first.
Okay.
Because you asked me this actually.
Oh, I did for a TikTok.
Yeah,
for
TikTok. Okay. And I think it would have to be Sunny Malone in Xanadu. Just because it was just so fun to see you play that role. In your spray tan.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think it would have to be that. I don't know if there's, that's the one.
Mine for Trips is obviously Mary Poppins. I'm sure it's all of your favorite of hers too. Yeah. Oh, somebody might like Janet too. Two very different roles.
Yeah.
But yeah, Mary Poppins for sure. Yeah, this has been.
This has been a.
Episode
Very
3 of Successions. We're gonna sing you out.
Oh yes.
All right, here we go.
All right, here we go.
It's Declan and Tristan in a Couch Cabaret.
Yay!
All right, thank you guys for watching.
Episode three
of Successions of Couch Cabaret.
Thank you for joining us.
Yeah.
See you next week.
Bye guys.
Bye.